mistaking a boy for a rabbit. On Tuesday morning, a boy named Watt, residing in Quarry Lane, Irvine, was accidentally shot at Duntonknoll Quarry. This quarry was for many years infested with rabbits, but the lessee has nearly succeeded in exterminating them. At the time the accident occurred, the boy, who is employed as an apprentice in the quarry, was sitting down behind a stone, and in the gray light of the morning the lessee of the quarry, mistaking him for one of the remaining rabbits, fired. Some of the pellets have entered the boy's head, but it is expected that his injuries will not prove to be of a serious nature.
Brutal outrage at Irvine. Early on Sunday morning, the inhabitants of Irvine were thrown into a state of excitement by the intelligence that an assault of a very savage and brutal nature had been committed on the inmates of the cottage at Duntonknoll Quarry. Mr. Alexander Ritchie, proprietor of the quarry, his wife, and little daughter. The occupants of the cottage retired to rest for the night shortly after 10 o'clock. A little after midnight they were awakened by the breaking of glass in the window of the room they occupied, followed by a heavy smash inside, which proved to be a large stone from the quarry. The stone splintered, and part of it stuck in the front of a chest of drawers, where it still remains. Mr. Ritchie immediately went out to see what was the matter. He heard someone say, "I'll do for you," and was immediately felled to the ground by a stone, which inflicted a frightful gash on the right side of his head. Mrs. Ritchie carried her husband into the house, and was followed by the ruffians, who knocked her down, smashed, kicked, trampled, and otherwise ill-used her. She is shockingly cut about the head and body, and much disfigured by bruises. The rings on her fingers had to be filed off, they having been so riveted into her fingers by trampling. The little girl named Jessie made an effort to run for assistance, but was struck by a stone upon her forehead. She, however, still pursued her way to a neighbor's house, and gave the alarm. The police having been called, at once proceeded to the spot, and succeeded in apprehending three colliers, named Charles Ross, John McGowan, Benjamin Milligan, and an engine keeper named William Hopkin. The four men were brought before a Justice of Peace Court yesterday. Ross, Milligan, and Hopkin pleaded guilty, and were sent 60 days to prison without a fine, and McGowan, who pleaded not guilty, was found guilty of assisting, and was fined in £2 or 30 days.